this trail of Beatles Easter eggs bloody everywhere throughout the whole song.
The song is the
Unbelievable.
Beatles. The song is just
Yeah.
the Beatles. It's like every
And
trick
it's
people have
love,
ever had.
yeah. And it's just so much fun. I mean, any fun, it's like bloody loads of fun is what it is. Hey everybody, and welcome to another all-star episode of The Audiophiles. My name's John, his name's Andy, and as we say, it's all about the chew. And we are going to chow down on a tune, which Andy's providing. Andy, what do you got?
Have you ever heard of a band or artist called Coconut Records?
No.
Okay. We recently did we did Stuck on You recently in a reaction video, right? And we talked about Failure and their album Fantastic Planet. This when I was talking about them, I alluded to a documentary that was being developed, and that one of the contributors to the documentary was Jason Schwartzman. This is Jason Schwartzman's second stint as a musician, is Coconut Records. So he was originally in another band that was together for like 10 years, just about 10 years, or that he was a part of for like 10 years, and they were called Phantom Planet. This is what?
Phantom Planet.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got one of their things.
Yeah,
he's idea.
Jason Schwartzman's the drummer for that band and actually one of the founding members as well. Yeah.
I've just got one random track. I think I told you ages ago that I used to be part of this thing where you sign up and you got this guy's assembled through about 120 tracks every month.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just random stuff. It was new bands, unsigned, stuff he liked. And you didn't know what the hell it was. And that's how I got to listen to all sorts of bands before they even broke, you know. I'm trying to think of the Florence and the Machine.
Yeah.
So I was listening to them before their album came out or before they broke, you know, and stuff like that, and some early Seer as well, and all sorts of stuff. And Phantom Planet was one of them. Do the Panic as a track.
Uh-huh.
Ba, 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 ba. And it's just insanely catchy. It's a great, great track.
Yeah.
Jason bloody Schwartzman. Well, color me surprised.
Yeah, he
I
was
had
the
no
cover
idea.
For that, man. And I think he left around the early 2000s because I think his acting career was really starting to kick off at that point.
Yeah.
So he went into acting for a while, but he still couldn't really kick the music bug, right? So he formed this. It's just him. I mean, he just started writing songs, created this moniker, Coconut Records. He wrote all the songs for them, released two albums.
Yeah, cool.
And this is off the second album. This is one of two singles off the second album. And the tune that I want you to listen to is called Any Fun. So come back and let me know if you, after having listened to it, you had any fun, and we will discuss it.
Wilco.
Okay.
You never had any fun, so I won't come around. You never had anyone. So
okay, so the vocals sound a bit Beach Boys-ish, but that starting is really Beatles. This is interesting. I'm just going to listen to that again, because that was quite interesting.
You never had any fun, so I won't come around. You never had anyone, so I won't let you down. You never had any fun, so I won't come. Any fun, basement, all alone, with the high hopes. Alright. Alright. Well, it's a downpour, and the water, it is rising. And yes, she's a system, and the plan, so devising. Let's go.
Sorry, I'm listening to that bit again as well. It's like Spot the Beatles reference. There's just so many of them. And even that brass that came in underneath that weird sort of... There's a weird synth. And was there like a glockenspiel or some sort of metallic chime? And then the brass note comes in. Oh, man. This is full of Easter eggs.
Hell, been a hard day, and the hits keep on coming. Sit back.
He says something about help and a hard day, hits keep coming. I mean, that's just really on the money.
You never.
Song as well, and just loads of little interesting references and Beatles motifs scattered throughout. That was great. I enjoyed that. Back to Andy.
So
okay then. Yeah, interesting. Right, so not to sort of take away from any of the sort of, you know, merits of the song itself, which was great, fun, and catchy, but oh my god, it was just like this trail of Beatles Easter eggs bloody everywhere throughout the whole song.
The song is the Beatles. The song is just the Beatles. It's like everything.
Yeah. And it's just so much fun. I mean, any fun, it's like bloody loads of fun is what it is.
For
a Beatles fan, anyway, you know. So it starts off, I was a bit confused, because it starts off and it starts off with the bloody chord, you know, and I should have got it from that, but I didn't. And after the first, 10, 20 seconds, I stopped and said, well, this is a bit odd because the vocals are almost a bit sort of Beach Boys-ish, you know. But the music is slightly Beatles. But that start, you know, it starts piano, and then when it kicks in, the drum and the bass comes in at the same time. That is just so Beatlesque. It's unbelievable. And I'd have to say, when I say Beatlesque, I mean most of it is McCartney-esque of, you know, that side of the Beatles. Most of it. But it's just great. I had a huge amount of fun as soon as I got. Yeah, okay. And it's just like the way, I mean, but it's still lovely and it's fun and it's great and it's catchy. And his vocals aren't the strongest, but they're still endearing, you know. They're fine, you know. And then when he goes, he says something about Let's Go or whatever. And at that point, there's this weird synthy little break, which is at the same time, this sort of, his vocals are sort of mimicking it a little bit as well. And there's this like glockenspiel or sort of metallic chiming going on. Yeah. And then under that is this lovely brass horn. I don't know if it's an oboe or a French horn or whatever. You know, really sort of Beatles as well, which is just, it made me laugh out loud. It was so good and so funny. You know, it was just awesome. The staccato piano bits, which at some points became this galloping stuff, which is really McCartney. You know, I almost started to, you know, wobble my head as, you know, you imagine him doing it. But just great. I mean, yeah. Beatles harmonies as well. I mean, the vocals, really. And he says, well, I didn't, you know, had any fun, you're not, blah, blah, blah. And I didn't really pick up. But then one point, because it really stuck out in my ear for some reason, he says something, I'm sure he says, help, been a hard day and the hits keep coming. I thought that was so funny and on the nose. Yeah. When they're doing the had any fun, there's this lovely chord change, had any fun, and a chord change there, which is again really, really Beatles. And then they come back in again with the synth glock horn progression, but it progresses a bit more and it becomes almost ELO like, which is an extension of the Beatles anyway,
is
know,
it not
as right. concern, you know right. So it's great. And then right at the end, and of course they have this false ending, and it comes, it's about Let It Go, but it comes crashing back in. I think he says something like Let It Go or something, but that's like the only bit which is really John Lennon. It's really John Lennon, that bit. But overall, this is really, for me as a big Beatles fan, a huge amount of fun. It's a super catchy song anyway. And I just loved like spotting all these. And I'm sure if I listen to it again, I'll spot even more of these little Easter eggs of, like, you know, Beatles homage, as it were. And yeah, really funny, really great, brilliant.
Ah, I'm so glad you picked up on everything that I picked up on the first time I heard this, and what is the reason that, on top of being just a fan of Jason Schwartzman and his acting and his music, like, this would, like, I had to have this in my collection. I was like, oh my gosh, yeah, this is such a great, what better doff of the cap or, like, you know, homage has been.
It's well done. It's really well done. It's not just ham-fisted.
It's like 2 minutes and change of just like, I love the Beatles, here's why. And like, there he just lays it out there. And even you said, like, there's this like book ending of like the Illusions too, right? Where at the beginning, that just the strike of that chord, there's so many great Beatles songs. I mean, it's maybe the best introductory chord of all time is A Hard Day's Night, right? So he does that, and you're like, that's a mechanism I've seen before. And then at the end, where the track seemingly ended, and then you hear that, and like the pianos like run, like that's something, like so many of the, like the anthology tracks that came out have these little extra bits of footage on them, or like, you know, audio of them kind of dicking around at the end and having fun. And that's such a Beatles thing that would find a way on the end of a track, that he does that, that he does that both things. It's like, oh, you're such a fucking genius, man. It's such an excellent way to, for the real lovers of the Beatles, to just comb through and Where's Waldo every goddamn part of the song. So yeah, I really am stoked that you picked up on what I picked up on when I listened to that. As stated before, it's the second album. So the first album he did was called Night Timing. It came out in the summer of 2006. And it's really interesting because who helped him with that, as he sort of dipped his toes into more of a production standpoint and putting like assembling all these moving parts as opposed to just being a drummer was none other than Mike Einzinger, a guy that I love, one of my favorite guitarists, the guitarist from Incubus, is who he tapped to help him do all the production work with this. And he also tapped other actors and musicians to appear on it, including Kristen Dunst, Zooey Deschanel, Brandon Boyd of Incubus, Ben Kenny of Incubus, and Robert Carmine, who is his brother. So it's just really interesting that that was like his first album. And then just 2 years later, he came out with a second album. I think it was two or three. Davy is the name of the album that on which this features. Both albums are really good. I really wish he would come out with something else if he could find the time, if I'm not asking too much. He's also done some other incredible music stuff, like the really great Judd Apatow sort of comedy that tugs at your heartstrings. It's called Funny People. He did Schwartzman did the entire musical score for that, and some of the tracks from Davy were on that. Just a really interesting guy and kind of a jack of all trades when it comes to like the entertainment industry or whatever. So yeah, I'll go over the lyrics a little bit because they fun. Said, you never had any fun, so I won't come around. You never had any fun, so I won't let you down. You never had any fun, so I won't come around. You never had any fun, no. Down in the basement, alone with the high hopes. All right, all right. Well, it's a downpour and the water is rising. And yes, she's a system and the plan so devising. Let's go. You never had any fun, so I won't come around. You never had any fun, so I won't let you down. You never had any fun, so I won't come around. You never. All right. Help in. And the hits keep on coming. I said back to the old way. Yeah, just a long distance running. So you had little. So we had a little argument outside of the bar. If you get in our apartment to get out to the car, make it look real when you pretend to feel all right. All right. You never had any fun, so I won't come around. You never had anyone. You never had any fun, so I won't come around. You never had anyone. So yeah, that's just it. Such a fun song. And that was like the main reason why I wanted to give you, like in the past, I've given you these heavy ones where I really want you to focus in on the lyrics and the meaning. This is just like an homage to greatest groups of musicians ever assembled. And I just thought it was really cool and a fun way. And I didn't want to give you too much information and I didn't, and you still latched onto exactly what I wanted to. So this is awesome. I couldn't ask for much more for a reaction from you.
I'm really, really surprised because I like Jason Schwartzman a lot.
Very funny.
Obviously,
guy.
The Wes Anderson films. And did you see the series Bored to Death?
Bored to Death. He also did the musical score for a lot of that as well.
Did he?
He selected the music from other artists, but also provided his own songs. I think the intro song to that is one of his. And yes, I love Bored to Death. That was like before Zach Galifianakis really took off, and he's that weird, awkward friend.
Ted Danson is fantastic.
Yes, yes. Yeah, it's a very good short series. If anyone hasn't seen it, go check it out. HBO.
That was pretty. And I'm a huge, huge fan of Wes Anderson as well. So, you know, anything he does is fantastic. And obviously, Mr. Schwartzman appears in a few of those.
Mm-hmm.
Great. Yeah, that really surprised me that this is him, you know.
Cool. Well, don't go doing too much of a deep dive until I give you another one or two tracks down the line. And then the leash is off. You can run wild with it. But yeah, I got a couple more in store for you. So especially this is my testing of the waters one. So I'll maybe in the future throw another one or two your way, sir.
His boy, I mean, obviously you've got these references, but you can tell that it's been done recently. The production and the kind of feel of the song is modern, you know. But it does have a feel of somebody else, but I can't think who, you know. Kind of his voice, but also the way the song's put together, it sounds like slightly like another artist, but I will figure it out who it is. I'm tempted to say Brendan Benson, but I don't think so.
Okay,
someone like that, but yeah, I will figure it out next time you give me one.
Okay, right on.
All right, this sounds exactly like Metallica.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for giving this a listen and like
I enjoyed it a lot.
Yeah. It's weird to thank you for reacting the way you did when it was just an organic thing that came to you, but like it went over so well. So I'm really stoked about that, John. Thanks, man. All right, everybody out there in the listening audience, let us know what you think of Coconut Records or Jason Schwartzman as an actor, or if you've never even heard of the guy or this band. I mean, it's
let us know if you've heard of the Beatles as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Little group. I think they're, where are they from again, John? I can't recall. Yeah, but let us know what you guys think, and like, share, subscribe if you feel so inclined. But until the next time, John and I will see you all on the next episode of The Audiophiles. See you guys.